Hello friends, welcome back to my YouTube channel Mirror of Psychology. Please subscribe this channel for more psychology related information. In today's video, we are going to discuss about Guilford's structure of Intellect model. Guilford's structure of Intellect model was introduced in 1950 by Troy Paul Guilford. Guilford and his associates developed this model of intellect after conducting several intelligence tests on different individuals. What they realized is that every intellectual activity or mental forces can be explained using three basic dimensions. These dimensions are operations, content, and products. First is operations, which is how we think. It's all about the mental processes that we use to solve problems or think. Guilford identified five such types of operations. The first one is cognition, which is the ability to understand or become aware of the information. Second is memory, which is the ability to recall and retain information. For example, remembering a new fact, then recalling it later. Third one is divergent production. It's the ability to generate multiple solutions to a single problem, often associated with creativity. For example, if you are asked what are the possible uses of a hair clip, then a divergent thinker might say that it is used to tie your hair, can be used to unlock a door, it can also be used as a bookmark. Fourth is convergent production. It's the ability to find a single best solution to a problem based on multiple facts, often associated with logic and reasoning. So convergent production is about finding one correct solution. For example, imagine a detective trying to solve a crime. So the detective uses various clues and facts to conclude that the suspect is the person who committed the crime. Last is evaluation, which is the ability to judge whether the information is correct or if the solution works. Next, we have contents. It's the type of information being processed. Guilford broke this down into five categories. First one is visual, which is the information we see, like shapes and colors. Second is auditory, that is information we hear, like sounds or spoken language. Third is symbolic, which includes things like numbers or letters, basically any kind of symbol. Fourth is semantic, which deals with meanings and concepts, usually through language. Fifth is behavioral, which includes information related to human behavior like understanding body language or social cues. The third dimension is products. Products are the results or ideas that come from our thinking. This is the form in which information is organized or used. Guilford identified six types of products. First one is units. It's a single piece of information like a word or a number. Second is classes, which includes groups of items that share something in common. Third is relations. It's the connections between things like cause and effect. Fourth is systems, which includes more complex structures like a mathematical formula. Fifth is transformations, which includes changes made to information like converting a fraction to a decimal. Sixth is implications, which is the predictions or conclusions you draw from a information. Guilford represented these dimensions in a 3D model for the structure of Intellect cube. Each axis of the cube represents one of these dimensions, which are five types of operations, five types of contents, and six types of products. That means 5 into 5 into 6, or 150 possible combinations of intellectual abilities. According to Guilford, every intellectual activity that we perform involves at least one element from each of these categories. So in a way, our minds are working with these 150 different factors to solve problems, learn, and create. Now let's understand how these three dimensions work together to solve a problem. Suppose you are trying to solve a crossword puzzle where the clue is a large wild cat found in Africa, and you have to find the word that fits. So first you will use operations. So you will use your cognitive abilities to understand the clue and figure out what it is asking for. Example here, it is asking for an animal. Second, you will focus on the meaning of words, which is the clue, large wild cat, and think about animal that fits this description. Lastly, you will connect the relationship between the clue and your knowledge of animals to arrive at the answer, lion. So this is how we use these three dimensions to solve our problem. Thank you for watching the video. If you have liked this video, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe my channel.